Hello students, welcome. Now we'll see the structure of materials. In the last lecture, we have seen that the processing is very important because it will decide the properties of materials. And we have seen the example of steel. For example, if you have steel, if you process in a certain way, it will behave like a ductile material and you can draw thin wires from that. If you process in some other different way, it can behave like a hard material and you can make gear out of the steel. So what is important here is the processing of the material. So the properties such as ductility and hardness depends on the processing, and this decides the performance of the material, right? So for the conclusion is, for better performance you should have a good processing, and for good processing you should have better structure. So now we'll see here what is meant by structure of materials. Basically, the structure is the internal arrangement of atoms. The book's definition of structure is the internal arrangement of atoms. So from atoms we will see now there are some levels of structures. We will see starting from the nucleus, which is the smallest part of the structure. So nuclear structure is the smallest one and the macro structure is the largest one, and this will go like this from nucleus to the macro level. Now we will see one by one. First is nuclear structure and the electronic structure. The smallest component of the atom is nucleus, and if you want to measure the spin of the nucleus or if you want to measure the magnetic properties of the nucleus, you have to use NMR, that is called as nuclear magnetic resonance technique or MOSFET technique. Now the next component after nucleus is electrons. If you want to know the band gap of the material or if you want to know the transition levels present in the electrons, you have to use EV visible technique or FTIR, that is the Fourier transform infrared technique. Now first nucleus, that is this one, then there are electrons. If you combine these two you will get atom. So if you want to know the atoms, whether there is a periodic arrangement or whether there is non-periodic arrangement, that you can see by using X-ray diffraction, neutron diffraction or electron diffraction, and that we called as crystal structure. Now you should remember here that magnification is the action of magnifying something, and it is basically to enlarge the size of an object to observe it closely. For example, I have an object like this. So this is the object. If you use a magnifier here, this is a glass magnifier, and you enlarge the size of object by 50 times. So this I can call as magnification by 50x. Magnification by 50x. Now there is another term called as resolution, and that means to distinguish between the smallest size of the particles separately. So for example, this we have two objects. So these are again objects. The distance between these two is 10 nanometers. So if you can resolve this 10 nanometer distance, if you can see this 10 nanometer difference clearly, that I can call as 10 nanometer resolution. because we will use this term in the next slides. The next level of structure is called as substructure. I have an object like this shown in white color balls. So if you zoom here, if you zoom this area, for example, if you zoom this area under a microscope and you magnify that object 20,000 times, you will get structure like this. This structure is called as polycrystalline structure. This we will see in the next slide. You just have to notice that this structure is different than what we can see by naked eyes. So we can see only the polished surface by naked eyes. If you zoom it further, we can see the grains. These are the grains, or these are we can call as microstructure. This we can see by using scanning electron microscope, and the magnification is 10 to power 5x and the resolution is 2 nanometer. If you again zoom this area, for example, if I have taken this area, we'll choose this area, and if you again magnify this area, you will get atomic level structure, right? So these dots you can see, these are the atoms. This white color dots are the atoms, and this can be seen by transmission electron microscopy. Its magnification is 10 to power 7 times and the resolution is 0.1 nanometer. So this is substructure. We have an object that we can see by naked eyes. If you magnify it further, we can see the grains or microstructure, or if you again magnify it further, you can see the atoms. So this one, and this one we can call as substructure. So for observation of substructure, you should use electron microscope. So in the last slide, we have seen the microstructure and we have seen the grains and how the grains are formed, that we will see here. So if you melt any material, it will go into the liquid state. Liquid state, we have atoms here. For example, these are atoms, individual atoms. We can say these are unit cells. Unit cell is the smallest component of crystal structure. This we will see in coming slides. You should remember, you can say that these are the atoms. If you cool it further, these atoms will come closer. These atoms will come together and they will form a solid structure. So in solid structure, what will happen? Atoms having similar orientation, or we can say atoms having similar energy, will come together and they will form different regions. Those regions we can call as a grains. And what we can see in this structure here, this we can call as a grain, and this line we can call as grain boundary. Again, you can see in this picture, this is a grain, this is a grain, and this in between 2-3 grains we can call as a grain boundary. Each grain is a single crystallite in nature, and single crystallite means the atoms are arranged periodically, and grain boundaries generally are amorphous in nature. So I will tell you what is mean by single crystallite and what is mean by amorphous. So materials we can classify into broadly two types. One is crystalline and one is amorphous. The crystalline material will have periodic atomic arrangement. The amorphous structure will have non-periodic or random atomic arrangement. So if you see atoms in amorphous material, the atoms will look like this. We have already seen in our earlier lecture. These are atoms, they are arranged in non-periodic fashion. For crystalline materials, these atoms are arranged in a periodic fashion. Now, if we have, for example, lot of boundaries in between the disperiodic fashion, that we can call as grain mode. Crystalline again we can divide into two types again. So crystalline again we can divide into two types, single crystalline and then polycrystalline. Single crystalline will have periodic arrangement till infinite distance. So it will be like this. These atoms are arranged in periodic fashion. In polycrystalline, the periodic atomic arrangement will have some boundaries that we can call as grain boundary. So this is the atomic arrangement in one grain that is different from another grain. So this we can call as grain number one, this we can call as grain number two, and this is grain boundary. The next level of observation is called as microstructure level. So here we can see the microstructure using optical microscope. Optical microscope has resolution of 10^-7 meter, of 10^-7 meter, and it has magnification of 1500x. The last level of observation and the biggest level of observation that you can see by naked eyes or using some microscopic tool such as magnifying glass, but not optical microscope, that we can call as macrostructure. So macrostructure has magnification of 50x and resolution of 10^-4 meter. So in this wood, this lines, we can call this as texture, and texture here is the macrostructure and not the entire wood. Similarly, the lines of the hand are we can call as texture, and the texture is the macrostructure here and not entirely the hand. So whatever you can see by naked eyes is not the macrostructure. The texture, that we can call as macrostructure. There are some assignments based on this. I want to pause here and try to solve these assignments.